Merlini, woo. One hand.
God. Okay, I'll get a draft.
So, pretty typical ban, first man X. I expect a Doom ban or something pretty soon, maybe a Bounty Hunter as well.
Moo plays pretty nasty Doom.
Yeah.
So, probably Doom.
Oh, an Enchantress? Not that surprising either. We've seen a lot of first pick Enchantresses as well. Or at least first phase Enchantresses.
Bounty Hunter, Earth Spirit, pretty good contenders.
Yeah. I think you said you felt Enchantress was a little overrated.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Beastmaster, Ursa, Nyx, Lifestealer, yeah.
Okay. Fair enough.
Hurricane Pike, gimmicky.
Yeah. Pretty good against Enchantress. Alright, well, this is the new DC lineup. I believe this is the first time they're playing an official match in their new house. They have played officials before, but they've been like all over the place, not all together. I think this is the first one where they're all together now.
Tell us a little bit more about this team, Charlie.
So this is a very last minute team, sort of the in some way European rejects, to be a little bit blunt about it. Misery and Resolution kicked from Secret. Misery and We kicked from Secret. Resolution left for the American waters, leaving the CIS region to join Aoi and Bulba on the old DC, along with Soxa, who's going to be part of that team. But with the roster reshuffles, we have this iteration now, along with Mu from Archon. And I think DC probably ended up with a better team than, I guess, what they had previously with Bulba and Aoi. We'll see how it works out. We'll see how the chemistry really works together with these members, and how we really adapts to this scene and this new team. Previously he had issues with his previous members before, and how hard he worked, how well he worked with his other teammates, and we'll see, does his individual talent shine through here, or is he going to learn a hard lesson in taking things seriously?
All right, good speech from Charlie. And keep in mind, these two members did win the last major.
They did. These are major winners.
Yep.
But pedigree really doesn't mean too much in this game. Aoi and Bulba also contributed to a TI win on the last DC. They didn't accomplish too much on that lineup.
Blame the other three. Well, the drama may have faded from DC, but our expectations have not. Where do you think they rank in the American region?
I think right now I would consider them the second best team to Shazam.
Hmm.
Well, at least in this regional qualifiers, not talking about Cole EG. Yeah, but I think right now they're the second best team to Shazam. I think they definitely can take those games off of them. Before, when they played Shazam, like I said, they were like all over the place. They had Europeans playing on American servers from Ukraine, so it wasn't the most ideal conditions for them, and they had just formed. So I think they have a good chance to take this qualifiers here. They're definitely one of the favorites in this for the American regional qualifiers.
Excellent. Yeah, that we have the lowdown on our new team, Digital Chaos. They have led with an Alchemist Marana, the exact same lineup
that we saw
last game.
Yeah.
At least the same opener.
Didn't work out that last time that well for FDL.
Yeah.
Not for FDL, but Enemy.
This is how you play it, guys.
Yeah,
let us show you.
Show them how it's done. The European's going to show them how it's done.
And Enemy GG opting not for the AA counter, but for instead the Lifestealer. Abaddon's already pretty good versus Marana. I'm actually very surprised that they took Marana at this point.
Yeah, I think is this the first time we've seen a first pick Abaddon here?
I believe so.
It's very interesting. I think after it worked out so well for them in the first game against FDL, they have a lot more faith.
Did it work out so well for them? They won, but
they won.
They won.
They won.
So let's pick Disruptor again.
They got the Abaddon Knicks. They got the Abaddon Knicks, man. They're going with what won them games.
I like how they're, I think, attempting to play a little bit faster paced, though, and more team-oriented. Because they had the option of picking Alchemist and maybe a similar lineup to last game available to them, but instead they changed strats a little bit, maybe fearing, both
AA Digital and Chaos. Wrestler. Look at this. They've been doing their homework. Banned out the Tinker.
By homework, you mean just watch the games two hours before the match.
That's homework, right?
I would hope at least one of their five players watched it.
Hey.
Or their coach, if they have one.
They don't. Oh. They kind of do have a coach, actually. I know PyCat has been working with them in some degree. I don't know if he's, like, officially their coach, but he has been working with them.
Or they could have just looked at Twitter, just asked Shannon, could have asked
You think
us.
Shannon does any work with this team?
I think he probably watched a little bit of the qualifiers.
Too busy memeing, man. Alright, so Digital Chaos takes up the Winter Wyvern this time. Pretty good against Lifestealer.
They've really done their homework.
Yeah.
They watched more than 5% of the game.
Oh! Let's see what enemy GG responds with.
So you want to mix it magical. Some people will like Skywrath as a somewhat of a counter to Winter Wyvern. I would think actually Invoker is a lot better.
Yeah, Invoker is a lot better. Skywrath isn't that popular lately, but hey, they do pick it up. It's a good call.
It's one of those two because they have insane magic bursts for heroes that stand still, like just absurd amounts. I think I would suggest a Skywrath because I think he pairs a little bit better with Lifestealer, just because he's more like I don't know. I think your mid options you want to keep open for later.
Sure.
For most teams.
And he is also great at zoning out that offlaner.
Yeah.
It's something that we haven't seen that much this patch actually.
Yeah, people don't zone.
Yeah, people don't zone anymore. It's a lot of dual lanes. Offlaners, you know, still get a lot of experience.
And
even if they don't, you pick up an Iron Talon, you go to the jungle or something.
An Iron Talon we trust. Skywrath's also really good for Smirana, and Alchemist, for that matter. If you get the Ancient Seal before their defensive cooldowns, they are just dead. And they don't have Abaddon available to them. Or Abaddon.
You're going to catch yourself doing it.
I want to slap you if you say Winter's Curse instead of Cold Embrace. And you can slap me if I say Abaddon instead of Abaddon.
Abaddon. You're going to... They only have one hero with wings this time.
There's still two more picks. There's probably some sick cosmetic that we don't know about.
Lifestealer wings or something.
Okay, now it just sounds like we're advertising for Red Bull.
I can't do that.
What did I say I was advertising for? Can I hear the words coming out of your mouth, Charlie?
What, Red Bull?
Yeah. Are you allowed to say that?
Yeah.
Oh.
I don't work for EG anymore.
All right, Digital Chaos. What else do they want? Probably, I wonder if they want to set up for Mirana.
Maybe they pick their... Well, they do have some setup with Alchemist, with Wyvern to some extent.
I don't think the Alchemist mid want to skill stun, though.
No, you definitely don't. You should get at least
I think
a level or two.
I think Shadow Demon is really good. He's really good versus Sky, and he's really good versus Lifestealer.
Yeah, and he pairs really well with Mirana and the Alchemist. So they do pick up the Mu hero that should be the Nature's Prophet offlane.
Yeah.
He is a staple of Mu's hero repertoire.
He plays MP and Doom.
Mm-hmm.
By far the most that I've seen.
Absolutely. And see what enemy GG goes for. That's probably a BSJ Lifestealer again. They need a mid hero and Abaddon could be run as a 4 or a 3, but looks like it'll be a 4 Abaddon this time, as Batrider should be in the offlane, or could be mid.
Batrider is really good versus MP, he's also really good versus Winter Wyvern, and as we saw, he was actually pretty good versus Alchemist.
Oh. It's also really good with the Skywrath. You can just lasso somebody into Mystic Flare.
Explosion.
Exactly like that.
No, I remember I was talking to some guy at TI, except he didn't speak that much English.
Okay.
And he was trying to describe Skywrath. He's like, oh, you know, the hero, he has wings. I was like, dude, I don't know what you're talking about. A lot of heroes have wings. And then he goes, ticka, 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 ticka. I was like, oh, I know what hero you're talking about. Because it was when that Immortal came out, and he has like, those like swords coming from the sky.
Okay.
And I was like, if that's all you heard every game.
I don't know. Ticka, ticka, ticka could be so many things.
but with wings.
Okay. Hey, they got another winged hero.
It was just when that Immortal came out. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
See? Two.
That's also like there was another like taunt that sort of did that. Shadow Fiend, you know, when we went.
Oh, my.
That was annoying.
They nerfed it.
Good.
Yep.
You know the Peruvians like spamming that at Frankfurt?
Yep.
I mean, it was hilarious, but, you know, after a while, it gets old.
It's not funny when you lose.
I mean, it's funny for the people watching when you do it and you lose.
I like the dropping items a little bit more.
Oh yeah, that's risky. That's got real game in-game impact, man.
Yeah.
All right, so enemy thinks that enemy thinks that's going to be
support
a four
Marana.
Position Marana, yeah, with a Juggernaut ban.
Is that so?
I think it probably will be as well, actually.
I think with Jug, though, they'd be super farm dependent.
Yeah, I agree. That's a little too greedy.
I'd like to see a little bit more fight.
I think Wii is probably actually going to play the Alchemist.
Enemy GG, they need a little bit more scale, I would say. Now that Tinker isn't available to them, who's it going to be?
Wait. That is a mid-Batrider, and that is an offlane Abaddon.
Man, that's pretty risky. This is a single core.
Yeah, single core Lifestealer, man.
Versus Alk.
Versus Alk and Nature's Prophet and Winter Wyvern.
10 seconds remaining. He has wings.
I hate you so much.
Digital Chaos, yeah, I don't even think I think with this, they already have enough late game. They could even
bench.
Okay.
Okay, so not a four position Marana.
Okay, yeah, down with this.
So yeah, Wii Alchemist, mid Marana, and then offline natures. Bad. I like it.
I think that mid Marana is probably a little bit better than a mid Alk because Marana is much less likely to die to bat, although Skywrath rotations still do pose problems, as do Lion rotations. I guess that's where Vengeful Spirit comes in.
I mean, that's still better than, you know, Alchemist. Yeah.
Alk, you just really do not want to die at all in the first 10 minutes. Like,
and
zero
there's,
times.
There's not much you can do about it. Marana, you can at least leap. You can at least see us more safer than an Alchemist.
Mm-hmm. That hero in the middle? Who's Soxa playing?
Soxa's playing the bench. Oh, no. Sorry. The Wither
Jesus.
Wyvern. I hate you so much, man.
I'm amusing myself too much. Anyway, here we go. Game one, Digital Chaos versus Enemy GG. On the Radiant side, we have Soxa on the
Winter Wyvern.
Yep, TPing to the mid lane. Two Observer Wards on him already. We have Misery playing to support Vengeful Spirit. Resolution on the mid Marana. We on the Alchemist. Actually, are they going mid and Resolution, I think, is actually going safe lane because he has a Wraithbane recipe. So safe lane, Marana plays by Resolution. We on the Alchemist in the mid lane. Mu on the NP. And on the side of enemy GG, who's already smoked out, going to the Radiant Jungle. Flying Zebra on the Lion. Banana Slam Jamma on the Lifestealer. Sovereign on the Abaddon. Frozen on the Skywrath Mage. And Slayer taking up the Vanguard as the Batrider. Sorry, taking up the rear. Vanguard, ew.
Vanguard,
I just like I know.
Oh, is Misery going to get caught up? Gets hexed?
Then I was like, wait, that's not the right word.
And Tarred, and
ESJ does have open wounds. He does not.
But he gets arrowed and blocks the path for the rest of his team, and Misery will be A-OK.
Hey, they have trees. They can eat it.
Well, now they know that enemy is all bottom. BSJ should be able to get the bounty rune top.
No, we.
Yeah, I... We should we. Get the bounty rune top.
Yep, he has it. That's money. Yeah, that's one of the bad things about safe lane Alchemist, though, is you don't have good access to the runes. So, well, let's see if they can protect him, though.
Yeah, it'll come down to that. How much can Slayer do mid? Batrider is... Like, Tard does a lot of... Tard, Sticky Napalm does...
Tar.
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 Sticky Napalm does do a lot of work against the... against melee heroes, so... Be an okay matchup, but he does have Soxa on the winter wyvern to babysit him a little bit.
Wow, you're really enunciating that. I like that.
Yeah, it's because I hate you.
And Sovereign doing pretty well in the offlane. By that I mean his block is pretty decent, but I'm not sure if he's going to get any experience. Well, he did get
the lane is
that
gonna,
range creep.
The
he's
lane
good.
Is going to push for DC. So,
oh, so arrow comes out. A couple of right clicks. Is it going to be enough?
Nope. No. But he's not going to get experience after this.
Oh, he got the range creep. That's all that matters, man. I think he's fine. He can like hide in the trees on the right side. Yeah, he's good.
Yeah, I guess he should be able to get level 2.
Oh, they do have boost on misery, though. Let's see if Resolution can't connect with the arrow over here. He's kind of like in that weird spot where he's not able to use that range creep to tank the arrow. Well, he really wants level 2, so he can Frostborn and trade with misery. But another deny.
Well, Sucks comes back to lane as well.
They do see him, though. They have the nifty observer ward on the right side, or left side. And I'm just getting everything switched up today.
So, casting a lot of Dota.
A lot of great Dota.
A lot of American Dota.
Synonymous.
Yeah, lots of Dota with wings.
Jeez. And don't forget, they do have the Nature's Prophet. Actually, Abaddon has the Quelling Blade to start off with, so not really scared about that.
He's probably going to pick up an Iron Talon, just go and hit those neutrals.
Alchemist got his second Bounty Rune. 2 for 2. And he had 2 points in greed, so he got the value Bounty Rune.
Yeah, what a lucker.
Yeah.
Weehaw.
He is going to be so rich. Last hits is not that great, though, all things considered, which means support's toddling around the mid lane on the side of the Radiant. I guess he had to leave to get the 2-minute rune, so that's probably that discrepancy.
He'll catch up. It's an Alchemist. And Soxa did come bottom for a little while.
Mood doing pretty well in terms of surviving on the top lane, but out of mana, out of HP, forced to go back to the neutrals.
Did he start out with Tangos? Or not Tangos, Clarities?
I'm not sure. I think all good NP should.
Jacob?
Nope.
Jacob?
No Fairy Fires.
I don't think Mood started out with, I don't think he started out with Clarities.
Not sure. Anyways. Mid lane, player making some moves on Wii. Not enough napalm stacks. Do you even invest in a stick here? I think it's almost always a no-brainer.
No, you definitely should. It's still value.
But you're an Alk.
I mean, so what?
I don't know. It's regen.
Oh. While we're talking about that, Misery and Resolution do pick off the Baden with a
you thought about that.
I'm always gonna think about it now.
Two heroes smoked in the mid lane, Frozen and Flying Zebra trying to get a retaliation kill, but Wii is gunning for that 4-minute rune bottom, which he knows is very, very safe with those two supports huddling. Good play by Wii.
And he gets goes for the stack but doesn't get it off. But still a nice try.
Getting money though.
Cash. Yeah.
Is Morana going for Treads or the Midas? Midas. Oh, BSJ hasn't made any signs of building an armlet quite yet, and they're doing the wraparound. Are they going to be able to kill Mu? He does not have any treants available to scout, and as soon as he pokes his face, oh, yep, there they go. Flying Zebra, Frozen, closing on him, Hex to follow. We see Avenge TP, and they really want this kill. Do get one kill, but Frozen dies. That low armor not paying off for him, and only one kill. This is pretty good, I would say. Better for enemy GG.
Definitely. They got the 2 TP rotations, and they get out with the kill on the offlaner, and only had to trade a support in return.
Yep. I think BSJ like missed the wave of farm, though, and Abaddon is able to pull the creeps on the bottom lane, slowing down Resolution's Midas. And we see a scan.
That is a huge stack, by the way.
Oh, well, they scanned it, but I don't know what they're going to do about it. He's already there, and he's already taking it out, and he has loads of money. I think that's an armlet. Oh no, it's just a helm. I thought it was 5-minute armlet.
That would be insane.
We saw Beza get a 6.
Yeah, off of
Oh, is okay. it? Oh, itself. Oh. That was close.
Oh, that nighttime gank.
Oh, Moo. Okay.
Moo's second death.
It's not so bad for him. At least he didn't get the Alchemist. Alchemist is Mr. Moneybags. And P is actually very poor, even poorer than the Baden, who hasn't been able to get that much CS in the bottom lane.
He's just living.
I like enemy GG. They control the opponent's jungle very well when they're on Dire.
I feel like
that's an everyone thing.
Yeah, that's an everyone thing. Ever since C-Deck at TI5, everybody sort of does that, you know, run into the enemy jungle.
I guess they have to with their lineup, too. I'm giving them too much credit.
Nice, Merlini.
Okay.
Well, and they do take... Batrider does take that big stack from the Radiant Jungle. That's pretty big for him. That actually brings him pretty close to his dagger. Only about, 300-400 off?
And we see Hannah Midas actually being the item of choice for Banana Slam Gemma. Get that Midas. Green. Does he Midas in range? Nope. You know, some people say you should always Midas in range because
yeah, I've heard that as well.
But sometimes you do, you can't get the creep. Like your Moo is hardly likely to feed him trance, so you're getting a creep that you pretty much weren't. And no blink dagger, but we taking the tower, not enough armor, and we'll die. And that should be the blink dagger coming up for Batrider, and nice making a play before the blink. That is
and now
a nice
he has
one.
It.
Yeah. That's a really big kill for him.
Yeah, I'm really impressed by enemy's movement this game.
Yeah. Are we giving him too much credit? Nah, that was
really good. No, that was really good.
That was really good. Look, Batrider Riders neck and neck with Alchemist Net Worth.
Yeah,
the heck?
It should never happen. I like their rotation top. Their movement into the jungle. They've been on top of their
How do you have enough mana for that? Like he just took the stack out on bottom. I guess maybe that's what Wii's thinking. You don't expect that, because you Firefly on bottom, he has to wait 40 seconds, and then you have to have Firefly plus Lasso plus Sticky to go for that kill. I guess, it's the imp buff. Or the base mana buff.
Oh yeah, everyone got a...
Yeah. Batrider, one of the few innate heroes that actually had issues. Yeah. Sovereign, almost level 6. Oh, and
that's...
Oh, dang, I haven't seen that in ages!
Old school.
Old school indeed. Moo, will he burn down? He is... trying to find a place to TP out, and he will.
He'll get away. But, that's
some good economic
that's
damage.
Marana dying.
This is still a Midas.
And he did get it off before he died.
Still, that's... I think DC are in a position where they're like, crap! Batrider, making plays without Blink Dagger. Now he has Blink Dagger, and they have Midas.
And he didn't use Lasso. So he still has it up, he can still go for the Alchemist, but it looks like he's going to get that Ward CM. Yeah, yes it did.
However, you only have single core. Single scaling core, that is.
Yeah, late game DC should be able to take this.
Can they make it to late, though?
That is the question, right?
They need some more involvement from Moo. I guess they want to push towers, but...
Yeah, he hasn't done a lot of, TP ganks. He's just been trying to get his levels.
That's what you have when you have an Alchemist, though, and a Midas Marana. We talked about their lineup requiring a little bit too much farm, but we didn't expect it to be this greedy. Mostly Moo dying twice. Almost three.
Oh. Well, we does have his armlet now.
They're doing a good job of spreading out the farm around the map, though. Like, Resolution is taking this, area over here. Wii's doing the mid and the top, they're never farming the same
ancients,
place.
Yeah.
Wii farming top lane, so they're actually almost neck and neck in terms of net worth. Again, not that great when you have an Alchemist on your team.
But they do have more cores.
Yep. Still be pretty confident if I were DC.
Yeah, I wouldn't be too worried. Maybe a little disappointed, but not too worried.
Yeah. They need level 6 on Misery too, so they can kind of stop the effects of the Batrider Blink. And Fest Bomb number 2 coming out. No smoke though. Looks like Ventral Spirit might be the target of this gank. But I don't know, it's kind of obvious. Sovereign with half HP, right clicking on tower. Could be a little dicey, but looks like Misery's just going to die.
Yeah, he's dead.
That's worth. Now that they get the tower.
I don't think they'll get this tower, they'll probably put some pressure or some damage on it, but unless DC just decides to straight up trade.
But DC are, they're already getting the top tower at Baden, TPing, making
yeah,
his
they're
way to
TPing
top lane.
Out. I don't think they're gonna be able to get this tower.
Who's gonna TP in to save this though? They have to TP in multiple heroes. They're already skipping the wave. Oh, actually, it's just BSJ down here. They don't want to contest it, man.
They should. This is just a free tower. Yeah, Misery's pinging it out. He's just like, you know, don't let this guy get it.
But Misery can't do it alone.
Definitely can't. And he's just walking back to the lane.
And DC aren't getting anything out of this trade.
They're just wasting time.
Well, Winter Wyvern's TPing in, and they are going to smoke. Can they actually kill him? I think Rage TP solves all your issues. Unless Ventral Spirit hits level 6, which he is not.
Somehow.
Oh, they're going for it. This is going to be a really tough one.
Nope. And PSJ's just going to walk away.
That was
a lot of free damage on the bottom tower.
And a lot of wasted time. Two supports, smoking. Yep. That's some good play by BSJ. Like, knowing that he should feel fearless down there.
The resolution, lassoed, silence.
Oh, that's a whiff. Yeah, he's still dead.
And he's actually pretty far behind, despite that Midas.
At least he has a Midas to fall back on. And you don't lose that much gold when you die. Actually, this guy is losing a lot of gold when he dies. Because his Midas is off cooldown. And he had 200 gold. I guess he bought his Aquila, maybe? Did he have his Aquila before?
But
I'm not sure.
He's not having a great game right now. He's probably not. This is not, you know, what resolution is used to.
No one on DC is having a great game at the moment.
Alright. Team speak issues?
Tormented soul issues.
for
it took you way too long
for the non-old school players. I wasn't sure if I wanted to respond to that. For the non-old school players, that is Lushrak.
You'll see people say like TS.
I think
the Chinese players say it a lot.
Yeah. But yeah, they still use like a lot of old school terms.
Yeah.
Well, we are paused right now. I think it's really important for DC to not really predict those Batrider ganks and be ready to respond in time. What they really need is for Misery to get level 6, and he's almost there. But until then...
Who ate that tome? Oh, Tome of Knowledge, stock 1.
Oh, they didn't buy the tome. Just give Misery the tome.
That's a big mistake.
That's not lit.
I hate you more than you hate me.
Yeah.
Stock 1.
Stock
1.
And it's, how long has it been? Has anyone even bought one?
When I play support, I have that on quick buy starting at like 7 minutes.
Yeah. It's so good.
Amazing.
Like, levels are so hard to find, and that just gives you like a free, almost like 3/4 of a level, depending on where you are.
Yeah, you see enemies, restock in 757. They have the right idea. They've been playing this patch.
Well, DC, you guys gotta get on the ball, man.
You guys gotta buy the tome. Gotta buy the tome.
Do they even have the money to buy the tome? They definitely have money to buy the tome.
Everyone has money to buy the tome. If anything, you buy, tell the elk to buy you a tome. It's that important.
That's true. Misery does need that level 6 real bad. So does Soxa.
Buy the tome, guys. Go. Okay, let's see how long it takes them to buy the tome. Shoot. Maybe they're wondering why they're not level 6 yet. Oh. Misery just hit level 6 off the wave bottom. Soxa about to hit level 6. Not off this creep, though. Oh, yes. Oh, it's a range creep. Okay, two heroes, level 6. Don't think they have a smoke on them. Oh, yeah, Venge does have a smoke. Wondering where they're...
They scan Flying Zebra. Oh, and
what
the arrow.
Scan.
Wow.
Wow.
Oh, resolution, though. Oh, but Slayer has no lasso, and
where?
They have no detection.
Okay. Radiant, you gotta buy Tome. Dire, you gotta buy detection.
Well, Slayer knows, just picks up that dust right there. Still no Tome on DC side.
Dude, what a scan.
Yeah, what kind of sense?
He probably expected a Batrider.
That's some great game sense right there.
That is.
Wonder who did it.
Probably Resolution. Because he's the one that's scared.
Now, what a player.
What a player. Because the supports are just chilling on bottom. If they were scared, they would have TP'd up top for a defensive swap. Oh, we see a smoke. Frozen and Slayer in the mid lane. Lasso is up. Haste ready on Batrider. No dust, though. And let's see. Okay. Nope. Yeah. He has dust. He's ready. And Misery is way in the trees.
Looks like they're moving bottom. They're gone.
That's a free tower for old Mr. Ancient Black Dragon. And now that they know no one's there, Dire, are they going to use their scan to try and find someone? Well, they
looks
know.
Like they're moving mid. Place a aggressive ward in the jungle. It looks like they're going for Soxa.
There they go. Well executed this time. Which learning from their last mistake. That was quick. Sovereign is a Quelling Blade. Wap is available. Looks like he's just gonna tick down to double Starfall, but
he's enemy. Do you get the tower as well? So I'd say that's definitely good for them.
Well, they have Radiant, so that's really good for them. Yeah. Still, no control of your own jungle. I guess with the top tower being taken down, plus the Observer Ward being there, they actually have access to one jungle.
I think Sox did ping out that high ground ward, actually. The ward in their jungle?
Makes sense. That's where they, you know, you wrap around, they didn't see anyone in bottom because the dragon was playing
so
very aggressively.
They should know it's there, they should deward it pretty soon. And, you know, DC's getting back into this game.
They just have tons and tons of farm now on Alk, and it's only going to get better with the Alk Radiance.
Mm-hmm. And Resolution's also, you know, climbing back up there. 3,000 away from his Ags. With that, you know, enemy really needs to take this time to pressure DC. I feel like they're trying. Yeah, they're also on a bit of a timer.
I would say a lot of a timer.
Yeah, their early rotations, which found heroes there, are kind of fallen off a bit.
It's because they found unimportant heroes with their kills.
Oh, well, they do get Mu here. This is pretty big. Good pickoff.
So. It's like the thing about it is they have Lifesteal or. Once they have Lifesteal or Radiance, they can't pressure high ground.
You mean Alchemist Radiance?
No. Steel Radiance.
They can?
They cannot.
Oh, okay.
Right, so like once they get that, what are they going to do? They might take Roche, and they might break T2s. Can they end the game? And if they don't end the game, then Alchemist will take over with his farm.
Right.
So that's where I'm worried for enemy GG. They need a way to break the high ground. Stick Lasso pickoffs would do that.
I mean, their best bet right now is just to get pickoffs with Lasso. And the Batrider is having a pretty good game.
They're farming faster than they're dying, though.
Yes. So if I were enemy, I would feel a little worried. I feel pressure to really do something to get the snowball going. And the thing is that they haven't taken objectives. All they've taken is that one tower bottom.
Oh, they have vanished, but no heroes are defending mid. Must look a little bit crazy for them. And they actually have a sentry already in mid lane. Dang, enemy are actually prepared too.
But like you said, they're not taking objectives. They can't really do too much here.
Oh, what a nice flame break coming out from enemy. Ancient Black Dragon on Mu's tail. Like no one on DC is even interested in helping Mu.
Oh no, they're coming down.
I mean, it's just Alk though. Alk's gonna die too if he stays around.
Venge is there, Wyvern's TPing in. Oh swap from Misery.
They got him.
Flamebreak's done.
I'm surprised they took so long.
Misery's not gonna die.
Wow.
And looks like there goes Slayer. Misery. Misery Dota, man. What a hero.
It looked like they weren't even going to try. I thought they thought that he was dead. I thought he was dead.
That was a dominating spree. 581 gold for that kill.
How did he not catch him with Blink and Force?
He was on cooldown. He used Blink and Force to catch up to him. He was so far away.
Huh. Interesting. Lifesteal could have just popped out and been wounded.
I just want to show you something, Merlini.
Okay. Tome of Experience.
Tome of Knowledge. Sock 1.
Ugh.
I still haven't bought it.
I wonder if they're going to go to a whole game without buying it. They might not be
familiar with it.
That'd be a tragedy. Okay.
Well,
Lifestealer farming away.
Ooh.
He's happy with that.
Yeah, and he's gonna get away. Can't really kill the dragon.
But his Midas is off cooldown.
Not value.
Not value. It's okay. I mean, he's mega farmed already.
And this should be a Midas soon coming out for the Nature's Prophet in about maybe 30 seconds.
They know they have better late game, and they know that enemy don't have a good ray to breach the high ground, so...
Might as well.
Are they maybe too confident, though? Nah. Maybe with, like, Ags, Abba they can, or, like, Solar Crest on someone, maybe? I don't know.
I mean, enemy really just needs to be able to pick someone off, and then take an objective. And then that's going to be their game plan. Like, rinse and repeat that way. But it is very hard.
They need BOTs on bat. Because the ganks are too few and far between. I think with BOTs, you'll have much better uptime on participation.
Lion needs a dagger as well.
Yep. Sky needs... Oh, he's going for Greaves?
Yeah, he's going for Greaves. Lion needs the dagger. Can't all just be on the Batrider to find pickoffs here. Because they need a lot of pickoffs to really take objectives this game.
They need more smokes. Actually, I don't even know if they have any smokes left. Oh, we do see Boots of Travel, but it's on Banana Slam Jamma.
Oh, that's interesting. I don't really know what... enemy's game plan is here. How are they going to win the game? They can get kills, sure, but in the end, that's not all that matters. And during this entire time, Resolution, who was like 5th or 6th in net worth, now climbed up to number 3.
That's before Zax.
Yeah, and he's only 500 gold away from it now.
They keep pushing out the lanes, and yeah, they're not really scared. Oh, early gem. Okay, that's a way to end it. That's a good way.
Yeah, it's a good way to limit vision, but even then, DC still has treants to scout.
Ah, they have double BOTs, man. It's happening. Two BOTs plus gem.
Alright, let's see what they can do here. I hope they do something quick, or, you know, this game is going to get really hard for them. It already is really hard for them. All right.
Oh, they think they're rushing.
Well, this might be an opportunity for enemy to do something.
Oh, vanish.
Well, looks like probably nothing is going to happen.
Good game sense by Mu.
Yeah,
he backed off way early.
He saw everybody off the map. His team was grouped up as 4, so... very smart by him to just move back. And they're going to take this bottom tower. More gold into the hands of DC, and enemy really need to do something here. They need to get something done, either like a pickoff, get objectives, something to force DC to respond. Because right now they're just farming.
A lot.
Yeah, and they're happy to do it. There's no pressure anymore. In the beginning, enemy had great, you know, map movement. Really pressured DC, but you just don't feel that anymore.
Oh, Slayer? What is he doing?
He's got a haste run. He'll be fine. Oh! Wow. Resolution gone.
Oh, and that's gem. Okay, well...
Alright, well...
That's really bad.
That's super bad. Wow.
I had high hopes for the double BOTs.
I mean, that's your favorite item.
It is, and it's important when you need to keep out pressure. But now...
But Resolution gone, man.
Yep. That was the one. That's the moment you're like, wow, enemy's boned.
Yeah, they might have had a chance, but that's gem lost, it's more time lost, it's momentum lost.
I don't know what he was doing trying to blink like that, though.
He was by himself too. It's not like he can really solo kill heroes anymore.
Holy MP. I guess
Actually, he can still kill, just not the.
It's gonna be hard. And it's gonna like take a long time, and yep. In that time, Nature's Prophet can also always TP. DC heroes can respond. He was really far in. Lion is still not that close to the dagger.
They need Roche. They need something.
Even if they try and Roche, like can they even take it? I don't think they can
not
safely
DC
take
could
it.
Test.
Yeah, they're all in a Roche pit. Only Lifestealer can really hit it against Acid Spray.
Abba can hit it.
Oh yeah, I guess Abba can hit it, but
I just think they need to. You're not gonna win this by farming.
At least they're. Oh, hey, he bought a tome.
Got it.
Misery bought a tome. He did it, guys.
Did he buy two?
I think he only bought one.
Oh, I don't see any in stock anymore. Well, here they go. Infested in the middle lane, but they don't know if they have wards here. They easily could. And BOT to the top lane. Are they going to be able to catch Mu? He's going to have to chase a long one. And he can probably.
He's out of mana. Oh.
He can just TP out now, right?
Oh, he's just gonna die.
Oh, close with the Glimmer
Cape. Saxor tried to be a hero, yeah, with that Glimmer Cape, but looks like he's just gonna get lassoed instead. And, well, he should be dead. Yeah, a little bit of a setback for DC, but overall, I don't think they're too worried. Alchemist is still farming. Doesn't look like they're gonna take it. Enemy is gonna take an objective off of this.
Both their lanes are pushing to T2.
Yeah. So in the end, it doesn't really do too much.
No, not in the grand scheme of things.
Yeah, like I said, enemy, they got to take objectives, and instead Batrider just dies.
They just scanned him too. Ha! Clever pun, Alchemist.
Oh, they're gonna go on Misery, but he. Oh, nice swap off of him and the.
That's gem though.
Oh.
That was a good swap.
Oh, but looks like the fight's not over yet. Sovereign's gonna get chased down. And
oh no, the gem!
The gem. That'd be it. And the gem is returned. Oh, okay. BSJ's going back in, and he gets cursed, and that's his rage duration. Crowded as well. And BSJ's dead, and that's a 5-man wipe.
Just try and curse in an arrow. Kinda cool.
Yeah, that's cute. Yeah, that's pretty cute.
Yeah.
Curse Arrow Sprout, yeah, I like it.
Like a 10-second stun.
Yeah. No, it's good. It's good. It's single core nakes, man.
That's true. Excellent for single core nakes.
Oh yeah. There's only one hero left on your team, yeah.
5v1, it's pretty good.
Yeah, this is a real rough game for BSJ, and he's trying to go for the poor man's alchemist build again. Going the Manta style. But he's gonna have a tough time against the real Alchemist.
Why'd they first pick Abba? That's really where the issue came in. Because they first pick Abba, they don't have a scaling core in their offlane.
Hmm?
I think Batrider's like half a core when he's because he can be ridiculous with like Scythe and Refresher and Nags and stuff.
But if you're just getting arrowed on the other side of the map
and losing gems. He's kind of forced into that position, though.
Yeah, he has to do something. I understand that he has to do something risky. But he should do something risky with his team, not by himself.
Now they're trying to deal with illusions, but there is going to be a constant wave of them with the Octarine recently picked up by Wii. And on top of that, he has 5,200 gold to boot.
Yeah, he's massive. He's a full like 11,000 gold ahead of that Nyx. This is that 25 to 30 minute timing you were talking about. Where
yep, he's god. He has AC.
Yeah. And he has money to spare.
That's scary. Well, X for everyone. X for NP.
A little bit of money to spare.
Oh, he's actually going. Yes. Going Force plus BKB, or is he going Scepter on NP?
He's going Force. Force. Oh, you know what he's gonna get? He's getting
Hurricane Pike.
Hurricane, yeah.
Hurricane Pike is great for single core.
Yeah, especially in X.
Is it good versus Bat? It's also good versus Lion. And just force stabbing the Hexar getaway.
Sovereign does get the deny on that tower, a little bit of a consolation in a game that's going pretty bad for him. Oh, arrow doesn't hit. Slayer's trying to scout in the woods, but he's not going to find anybody, and all the while, DC is taking Roshan.
Okay, Mirana is officially farmed.
She was farmed a little bit ago.
Now it's official, though.
Okay. you've denoted it?
Yes. Before he was like, eh, you know, he was just catching up with Midas. Now he's farmed. He can solo kill, I would say, anybody if he gets an arrow, and he can kill anyone without an arrow aside from Lifestealer.
Can he kill Lifestealer
with an arrow? I think so. He has double Starfall.
It's gonna be like 5 seconds or something. Maybe if he gets like unlucky with Radiance, the Radiance passive.
Things are grim.
Things are looking real bad for enemy right now. What do they need to do to get back in this game?
Kind of at that point where they made too many mistakes in the mid game to come back. Like the net worth lead is almost insurmountable. So
remember what we said though.
Yes, I think what they need to do though is kind of wait out Alchemist's farm. Like this is a strong point. You need to wait for him to have too much gold
and just go like super ultra late game.
Yeah, somehow. I think Abba might need a transition to carry. He is! He's Maelstrom!
Alright, he's trying to do it.
Wow. This guy needs like a Veil plus 8 toes and
maybe a Hex.
I think Ags is pretty good on him now.
Yeah. I guess that is the only thing that they can do, is just go super late game, but
I think Lion might have just should have gotten Midas instead of Blink at this point in the game.
Yeah, no, I agree.
Because you're not going to win in 45.
He's not going to look to get pickoffs anymore.
Yeah, he's too useless.
Well, that should be Frozen's life right there.
Okay, I don't know if they can stall out until Abba can be a carry, though. Two heroes dead.
They spread it up.
Oh, no. Dragon down. That's a max sprout. Dragon down. Rage.
Oh. He will be able to get away, but
he has no dragon. Resolution, aren't they going to actually sack the Aegis to try and make a play? The thing is, they don't need to. That's a sad part.
No, they don't really need to do a whole lot here. There's still a lot of room to grow for the rest of their heroes, minus the Alchemist.
Alchemist can still buy Ags. Ags Venge is pretty good.
Buy Ags Moonshard. Wyverns,
pretty good.
Ags Nature's Prophet.
Ags Nature's Prophet, yeah. That's still like, you know, 10 minutes of farm. It won't go to waste on Alk. Moonshard, as you mentioned.
Ags Venge is super good.
Yeah, I like it. As Venge, you usually just die instantly anyways.
Yeah, and then at this point, like, killing Ags Venge, killing the Venge is even harder for you.
Oh, arrow? Yeah, it is. Get any blink out?
Oh, the Winter's Curse.
They need damage on him, though.
Yeah. Oh, there's damage.
Oh,
but, Flying Zebra.
Yep. Getting to that point, everyone's just running away. What a sick sprout coming out from Moo.
Player.
What a player. Blocked into Skywrath, killed the Ancient Creep. All they traded was a measly Aegis on the officially farm Mirana. All three lanes pushing in. Things are looking good. Ghost is clear for DC to cruise on and take down
no
these
buybacks
rats.
From enemy.
Yep. Enemy, no, they're boned.
I don't know what they can do here. BSJ is trying to do what he can, but he is just a single core Nyx. he doesn't even care. He's just hitting the rack. He does not care about that Nyx.
Maybe he should care.
Oh no, but he's got Misery to bail him out.
Oh wow, and the Cold Embrace taking the T4s. That's a team play right there.
Misery the Hero is going to die though, but they do get that melee Rex.
Are they going to be able to get any rebuttal kills? Moo with another sick sprout, and an even sicker Earth Spike coming out from Flying Zebra. Glimmer Cape won't save you there, buddy. Soxa. Wow, man, Soxa. That was a sick play. I think a lot of Wyverns would have Glimmer Cape and then Chain Fed, but looks like he will be able to get away.
Yeah, this guy's a player, man. He is. A lot of people said really good things about him.
I like that play. That one play alone makes me think he's a good player.
Yeah, does what he can. And we have a Lincoln's now coming out for Resolution, who has been officially farmed.
Yeah, now he's over-farmed. He can kill anyone. And now they have protection for their Tower Seizure. Not like it's difficult, though, because they already broke mid. Man, Batrider's progression has been lackluster.
Yeah, he was doing really well in the first 15 minutes, and now he's just hasn't gotten an item. Can't really do anything. There's a lot of pressure on his shoulders to be the playmaker this game.
Remember when he was even on net worth without?
Yeah, man.
Octarine Core.
All right, if BSJ is gonna do this, I don't know why they just don't.
Yeah. Octarine Core, Manta. Now it makes me think that he didn't even get it for last game. Gets it because that's his build.
He just goes Radiance, Manta, Octarine Core on every single hero.
Yeah, Armlet optional. Yeah. Midas optional.
Well, I mean, they can't really take fights, so this is technically what they need to do.
Yeah. What other item could he have gotten? Bissell's crap. S and Y is also crap.
There's no single item AC? That's gonna, I guess.
AC is probably the best other option.
It's probably like the single best one for fighting, but even then, AC isn't gonna solve their problems. They're still gonna die to all this stuff.
But what's he stalling for?
The rest of his team to get items.
For the Abba to carry?
Maybe.
Blink Maelstrom. Oh, we trying to end the game while he's still hot. Trying to deal with.
BSJ is going to hit him with small little rocks in that siege creep.
Oh, going on Misery, but it sprouted up. He does get popped out of the sprout. We see, Batrider on the sideline, but Resolution again. Scouts him out, stops his Blink Dagger. They're good to go. Maybe wait for... I don't know what they're waiting for. I was about to say Alk ult, but he has Octarine, so all his cooldowns are already up.
I guess they're kidding. He ate a Moon Shard, so... I'll wait for the next creep wave,
So now he's officially 7-slotted?
Yeah.
He's maxed. Is Armlet replaceable with something?
He can still buy eggs.
Oh, yeah, but it's for himself. Okay, well, that was quick. They owned that Rax. Or own that tower. BSJ actually gets stunned up without rage. Almost dies, but he will leash a little bit. The lasso immediately canceled out by Misery. We still going in there. Very hot. Looks like he might be about to stun himself unless he mantas it off. Oh, nice timing. Does manta it off. And looks like they will end up with a T3 and about 1/3 of the melee Rax HP, but they aren't stopping there. We Chemical Rage Pop walking up the hill, Manta on cooldown for 10 more seconds. No ultimates up on the side of enemy GG, two of them healing in base, and they will just watch their Rax fall while the glyph is popped to little to no avail. And that is it.
Yeah, they really don't have the
what
damage.
What the arrow was that?
Flying Zebra.
Slayer, no chance of getting a decent lasso off. We'll force that back to safety. Resolution hot on his tail. Frozen getting chewed up by Wii. And that is another Alchemist ultimate. Not sure how they're going to handle this one. Will be the Infest into the Borrow Time into the Blink Out combo to save two heroes' lives.
You know, honestly, as far behind as BSJ is, he has been playing these teamfights pretty well. He hasn't died. He's 3-1-6, you know.
He hopped into an invulnerable hero.
Yeah, I mean, he's playing around his cooldowns really well.
He is.
But, you know, despite his efforts, it looks like this game is going to end pretty soon. As, what does the net worth look like? Dare I even look?
Nope.
Yeah, that's 40,000 gold.
Standard out game. BSDA trying to do something without rage, and doesn't look like he's able to do that much except for maybe hop into someone, run around a little bit, maybe pick off a little bit of Wii, and he is Dezo down, walk back inside to his death. Sega creeps. Bell GG. World Dire.
Game one to Digital Chaos.
I must say, they are, their strategy is solid, but their play has not been impressive.
Yeah, I think been a little sloppy. It's not what they wanted, or not what they expect out of themselves, I think.
Yeah, nor what we expect out of them.
Yeah, I agree.
Because they are major winners.
Maybe, you know, this next game they can clean it up a little bit. You know, first game of the day usually is not as crisp. They need a little bit of warm up.
Yeah, don't give Batrider a 7-minute blink. If he didn't have blink early, like, this game would have been
earlier,
ended in like 7-8 minutes
ago. For sure. Huh? I would like to see a little more movement out of Mu as well.
Mm-hmm. Well, congratulations to DC.